everyone, we're going to continue with building Flappy Bird in Visual Basic. Last lesson, you guys would have learned how to make an object fall using gravity, and we're gonna continue from that. So you should only follow this tutorial if you have done the first tutorial and you know exactly what Flappy Bird means. Okay, it's a very popular game. Okay, so the next thing we're gonna do is we're gonna make it so that when we press the space bar, the bird jumps or flies a little bit higher. So the way you do that is you're going to on your form, you're gonna double click on it, all right, which will bring you to the procedure that runs when the form loads. But instead of load, you're gonna click on the event, and then you're gonna click on key down, okay, because we want to do something whenever the user presses a key. Okay, so what key do we want to respond to? Well, the key that we want to respond to is space. So what we're gonna do is type in if statement, if e dot key code equals keys dot space, then we're going to change the y speed of the bird to a negative number. So why do we do that? Because if you imagine the bird is falling down, it will have a positive vertical speed or positive y speed of, let's say, 20. But as soon as you change it to a negative number, then what happens is it's going to instantly minus the number off your top position, which means it'll suddenly jump 15 units and then come down again slowly. So if you run the program now and you press space, you can see that you can make it jump up 15 units every time you press space, which is what we want to do. Okay, so this program is looking more and more like Flappy Bird now. Okay, now we're going to program the obstacles in Flappy Bird. And basically what we want to do is, instead of dragging a new picture box into our game, we're going to dynamically generate a picture box. Okay, so I'm gonna create my own function, private sub. Okay, so this is a function for creating enemies or I should say create pipes. And I'm gonna accept an input on how many pipes I should create. So it's an integer input. Okay, so dim I as integer equals 0. So I is just a variable I'm gonna use pretty soon. So using a for loop for I is equal to 0 to number. So this number variable comes from the input variable up here. For I is equal to 0 to number, dim temp as new picture box. So we declare a variable temp as a picture box. Now because you're declaring this variable, what's going to happen is every time we run through this, the temp variable, if there was something there before, it will be wiped out because you are declaring a new one. Okay, so we make up a new picture box called temp. We add it to our screen, add it to our program so you can see it on the screen. And then we specify the width of it. We specify the height of it. And then we also specify a border so we can see the border of the picture box. Let's change the color of it to red. Let's change the top position of it. And the left position, let's make it, to start off, let's just make it 300. I will show you how to change it soon. Okay, and then we're going to add this temp picture box to an array called pipe. Okay, so I'm going to scroll to the top where I'm declaring all the global variables, and I'm going to declare a variable called pipe, an array. A pipe array with, let's say, two spaces. Okay, so then I'm gonna add the temp picture box to my pipe array, and I'm gonna make it visible. Okay, so when I run the form, I'm going to create one pipe. Actually, that might create two pipes. Anyway, let's try it out. So temp.left, I'm gonna make it, if we run the program now, okay, you can see that there is one pipe at the end here. Okay, and so if we change this to, let's say, 100, the pipe is closer to us. Okay, but if we change it to I times 100, what's gonna happen is we should see two pipes. Okay, but let's make it I times 100, I times 200, and then let's plus another 100 at the end. So what's gonna happen is we should have two pipes, and they are more towards the right. Okay, now let's move them all the way so that you can't even see the second pipe. Okay, so the second pipe is out of the screen right now. Okay. Okay, so that's it for now. I'll see you guys next time.